ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ। ਸੋ ਸਾਧਸੰਗ ਜੀ, ਟੁਡੇ ਦ ਸਿੱਖ ਯੂਥ ਹੈਜ਼ ਔਰਗਨਾਈਜ਼ਡ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਇਨ ਰਿਮੈਂਬਰੈਂਸ ਆਫ ਆਰ ਜਗਤ ਮਾਤਾ ਮਾਤਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਕੌਰ। ਨਾਓ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਆਈ ਸਟਾਰਟ, ਦੈਟ ਸਮ ਆਫ ਯੂ ਮਾਈਟ ਪੋਜ਼ੈਸ ਅ ਲਿਟਲ ਬਿਟ ਨੌਲੇਜ about Mata Sahib Kaur. Now, if you find any discrepancies, I want to tell you where I found most of the resource that I'm going to be sharing with you today. And that resource came from the Gurdwara of Mata Sahib Kaur. And if a lot of you did venture and would go to Hazur Sahib and near Takht Hazur Sahib, near there is a Gurdwara known as Mata Sahib Kaur. And the correct name that they use, the full name is pretty long, but it says Gurdwara Ad Shakti Mata Sahib Kaur the Puratan Tapastan. That's the full name of the Gurdwara Sahib there. It gives you a very nice history on Mata Sahib Kaur. So Murli Vichar, the first introductory words that I want to share with you is there is a divine law, or you can say a law of nature. E kudrati nizama sache paashada, that Guru Granth Sahib Ji daste apanu jaise maat pita bin baal na hoi. And what is that divine law? It's something that's obvious to everybody that grows up, is that without a mother and father, there can't be conception. There can't be children. If you are going to have children, then those two have to come together in relation. And when we look through Guru Maharaj Ji and we read through Bhava Nakri and through Beant Shabd, through Tan Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji, we'll hear Guru Sahib, Paramatma, referred as Gurudev Mata and Gurudev Pita. When we look at that part of that pankti, when we say Gurudev Mata, is that what's what we're going to look into? Today, the vyakhya of Gurudev Mata is going to be Mata Sahib Kaur for us. Because you might say that that's the Lord we're talking about, but she's not separate from the Lord. She's part of that same light. God has been called the protector. God has been called the redeemer. God has been called the almighty. And God has been termed as this divine energy that works without the existence actually being aware of it. Unless you have a spiritual avastha, you do become aware of it. But God is an energy that's manifest everywhere. And that's something that you can only come to understanding with Mata Sahib Kaur's Jeevan. Now, before in Puratan India, when I included Pakistan, now you understand that after 1947, that division came when the boundaries broke Pakistan off of India. And because of that, we lost a lot of Gurdwaras, or you can say the Gurdwaras are still there, but Changi Sam Sabal hai nahi hun. That's why we do Ardas, that Samoo Gurdwara Gurtamaton, Jinna to Panthanu Vishodeya gaya hai, Khule Darshan Didar, Te Seva Sambal Hove. We do Ardas. Those Gurdwaras that are outside of our reach, some Gursikhs have even ventured to create books so you'll know the pictures and identify with those Gurdwaras, that at a later time, the next generation that comes up and goes on trips there, that they'll actually make an attempt to do seva, kar seva, for these pavitra sthans. Now, if you look towards the north of Pakistan, there's a district of Jhelum. Now, if you're to come from Peshawar, which sits pretty much on the border of Afghanistan and Pakistan, there's a road that comes towards Rawalpindi. But before Rawalpindi, there is a place a village, a small town known as Rohtas. The town is known as Rohtas. And if we, that district, like I told you, is Jhelum, the pind is known as Rohtas. And there's a small little building there that's not being taken care of now. We have a couple of pictures, we might even have videos, but there is no Kar Seva happening there. But hopefully something will inspire you inside of you after you learn about the Jeevan of Mata Sahib Kaur. If we rewind the clock to 1681, there in that spot that I had just been referring to, you'd find a family now. And within that spot that I'm referring to, you'd find this one father who has just become a father. His name is Bhai Ramaji. And he's sitting next to his wife. Her name is Bibi Jasdev. Or some say Jasdevi. These two are celebrating the birth of their child. They haven't named it. It's a baby girl that Bibi Jasdev has cradled into her arms. And Bhai Rama is reflecting of what happened during the birth. Bhai Rama had heard a voice when that child had come into the world, that this is no ordinary child. This child in the future will wed the master of this world. Will wed the master of this world. Tinhu jagat sambhal anand rachai. Then later on, this is the words of Bhai Gurdasji, the second Bhai Gurdasji, who is known as a poet or kavi in Guru Gobind Singh Ji's darbar, is that Guru Maharaj ne anand rachai will marry this child eventually when she is of appropriate age and then give her the task of looking after this world. Tinu jagat sambhal, jagat. That's why we recognize her as Jagat Mata. Ad Shakti Jagat Mata Mata Sahib Kaur. And they're reflecting because Bhai Ramaji had heard a voice. He had a voice telling him inside. And he shared this with his wife. Bibi Jasdev also reflected. And she shared with her husband. She said, when this child was conceived, when this child was conceived, at that point, I felt as if a holy, pure spirit had entered into my body. And when this feeling arose inside of me, as that child grew, so did my mind's peace. So did my mind's concentration. At times I would find I would be sitting in meditation. But before I knew no such concentration, that peace and concentration came with the conception of this child. Bhai Ramaji had turned to Bibi Jasdevi and he said, do you remember that time when we couldn't have a child? And at that time, there was a Gursikh that had approached Bhai Ramaji and he had said, don't despair. If no child has come into your home, come with us. There's a Sangat of Potohar that had collected together. And they were going to go to Anandpur Sahib. And one individual that knew Bhai Ramaji had come up to him and said to him, that don't despair if you don't have a child. Where I'm going, where this Sangat is going, and where I implore you come with us, there the impossible becomes possible. There what you might not believe is possible will become possible. You think you're not able to have a child? Well, do seva at Anandpur Sahib. There's a 13-year-old child named Guru Gobind Rai that anybody who comes into his house, he doesn't let them leave empty. Now, Guru Gobind Rai would be known as Guru Gobind Singh Ji, as you all know, after 1699. But But this is the years before. Bhai Rama Ji and Bibi Jas Devi, they get together and they join this group. They walk with them, placing one foot and then the next foot, and they would sing the praises of the Lord with the group, and they go towards Anandpur Sahib. That scene of Anandpur Sahib at the time of Guru Gobind Singh Ji, here we feel bliss when we go to that city of bliss. But imagine when you see Guru Gobind Singh Ji in his form sitting within this huge, enormous tent that's been set up, with six Sangata all over flocking to Anandpur Sahib. This Sangat of Potohar has also arrived. Bhai Rama, Bibi Jas Devi, together go up to the charan of Guru Gobind Singh Ji, or of Guru Gobind Rai at that time, had matha taked, and then they both shared in seva in the langar hall. Seva that Guru Gobind Singh Ji took note of. And when they were about to depart, Bainti, they would make this akhirli Bainti, this final Bainti before Guru Maharaj Ji. But before they make the Bainti, Antarjami that knows everybody's secrets, that knows everybody's desires, before they're even spoken, Guru Maharaj Ji turns to them, lifts his hand up into the air, and he says that the Lord is pleased in your service, in your selfless service. You did this to gain the pleasure of Paramatma, and you've gained it. The Lord now grants you a child. Go now, raise this child with love. Guru Gobind Singh Sache Pasha, at the age of 13 years old. They return home, ecstatic, overwhelmed, and surely they would find that Bibi Jas Devi now has become pregnant. And now, them holding the child, they are reflecting together. Well, as time passed, they decided, just short time had passed, they took a hukam nama, and sasa liklaya, the sasa or the S letter had come about from Guru Maharaj Ji, and they decided to name that child after careful deliberation, that this name should be suitable to the child's nature. They looked at Mata Sahib Kaur's face, and they saw it glowing. And they said that, first of all, it should include the fact that Guru Maharaj Ji, Guru Gobind Singh Ji, gave her to us. And it should include the fact that she's glowing from her face, as if the divine light of Paramatma. They wanted both of those to be in the name of Mata Sahib Kaur. So they decided on Sahib Deva. Sahib Deva has been given, Deva has been given by the master. And Sahib Deva, Sahib Deva, Deva also means light, Prakash, that the Lord's light. Carefully deliberating over a name and then naming the child Sahib Deva. Sahib Deva, after a short while, now is walking. Years have gone by, and as she's walking, she's holding her mother's finger as they accompany the father and they make their way to the Taramsal, the local Taramsal or the local Gurdwara Sahib. And every time she feels a magnetic pull to come back to the Gurdwara Sahib. While the father would go out to work, she would tell that, why once a week? Let's make it more than once a week. She would say to her mother, Taramsal de vich jana, Taramsal de vich jana, and the Mataji would respect the child's wishes. We always nurture the fact if a child says Waheguru, we want everybody to know that the child is saying Waheguru or doing something spiritually. Well, now Mata Jas Devi, while Pai Ramaji has gone to work, she takes Mata Sahib Kaur in a balak umr, in a child age, to the Taramsal every day. She teaches her the necessities of seva, of how to learn to do seva in a proper manner. And after she's growing up, they would make their way back before Bhai Ramaji came back. So because Bhai Ramaji also wanted to see his child, Sahib Deva, he would be rushing home to see his holy child. Well, it would be a short while after, Mata Sahib Deva is talking. Still in a young age, she now herself spends the whole day at the Gurdwara, sweeping the grounds, preparing prasad for any visitors to the Gurdwara Sahib, and also making sure that prayer is not far from her tongue. This is how she spends her whole days. And when it would start to get dark, she would go back home to greet her dad, to greet her father when he returns from work, and tell her of her day. She never spoke much. She spoke little. But when conversation of the Lord came up, that's when she would want to share in the vichar. Well, Khalsaji, now she's grown up. She's in her teenage years now, and she's gone to the height of 6 feet. That's what it's been said, 6 feet tall. And she's gone back as a daily routine to the Dharamsal, the Gurdwara, to do the seva. But she'd find that now seva she does, that her mind absorbs in Paramatma so much that wherever she's doing seva, she would sit down and go into this silent contemplation, this meditation she'd fall into deeply. As this dhyan, as this concentration grew, one day she would have a blessed vision. What was this vision? I want to share with you. Because there are panktiyan, there are lines sitting and Guru Gobind Singh Ji's bani, Sri Dasam bani, that reflect her past life. She saw in her vision, there is a woman who is also sitting in prayer and with her hands folded. Because she now had come to a conclusion in her life that she found no other man possessed the qualities she seeked in marriage. She found that no other man possessed the qualities she seeked in marriage. And she said, if I am to be wed, I want to be married to the Lord. Now we read through Tan Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji. Guru Granth Sahib Ji takes the perspective of a bride and the Lord is a husband. And in that manner, she is praying out to the Lord with her hands folded. Her spiritual avastha had accumulated from doing devotional worship, doing bhakti, that the Lord spoke to her. The Lord spoke to her. She had said, Asna kathu purkh nihara. I don't see any other individual that I want to marry in this life that possesses the qualities of Paramatma. I'm to respect my husband in the form of Paramatma, but I don't see any other that possesses those qualities. So if I am to be wed, I'm going to be wed to you only, Paramatma. So asna ka tu purkh nihara, fir ji mein e pant bichari. Then in her heart, this is what she contemplated. Baro jagat ke pateh sudari. Baro means to marry. If I'm to marry, is only to the Lord. She sees, Mata Sahib Kaur sees this image praying to the Lord. And then the Lord spoke to her. Again, a lot of us don't understand this communication. This divine communication doesn't just happen from you sitting down for the first time, for the first 5 minutes that you've ever prayed. No, it happens over countless years of you building that concentration so you can move past this material creation and connect with the divine. At that time, the Lord spoke to her. And he says that upon the earth, there sits evil. That upon the earth, there sits demons. I want you to do the Lord's work. And what you do is go take up the sword against this evil. Create a battle of righteousness. Stand on the side of the truth. And at that time, when you fulfill this deed, then your desire will be granted. She would do this. And this is a very long story that I'm going to summarize in very short sentences. She would go on the battlefield. And from where her capacity was, from where her capability was, she fought. And she brought down and slayed those that stood against the truth and that stood against righteousness. And at one point she saw that her capability couldn't go any further. And again, she took refuge in ardas, in prayer. She took refuge in ardas and called out to the Almighty Lord, called out to Sache Pasha Waheguru, and said, Sache Pasha, Sat Kaal Main Das Tihari. I've been your servant since Satyog. Sat Kaal Main Das Tihari. Apni Jaan Karo Pratipari. Now recognize me as your own and come down on this earth and take care of me when I need you. Hamai Saran Tor Maharaja. I'm in your sanctuary. I'm in your refuge forever, my Lord, my King. Tum keh bae gay ki laja. I ask of you to reach down with your blessed hand and take me by the arm. Her ardas was heard by the Lord. Maharaji hears ardases from the heart. He heard the ardas of this woman. This is Mata Sahib Kaur seeing this in a vision. And Paramatma took up a form that's been recognized as Mahakal. And what surpassed her capabilities, Paramatma came down and with ease was victorious. How we say, Waheguruji ki Fateh, that the Lord is always victorious. Paramatma was victorious, had brought victory on the land, had brought down evil and falsehood. He turned to her. That not at this time, but when I take up a form in an era of darkness, when I have need to come back to this world, then at that time, your desire will be fulfilled. Your desire then will be completed. We know this when we know, we recognize Guru Gobind Singh Ji as the form of Paramatma. Vap Parakateo, Bhagavan Turup. Guru Gobind Sura, in the town of Patna, the Lord embodiment, Guru Gobind Singh Ji, came about. And when he would make his way to Anandpur Sahib, he would give the blessing to Pai Rama Ji and Bibi Jas Devi for this child. Now this child has grown up. Now this child is 17 years old, 6 feet tall, spends her days in the Gurdwara. And as she was in this meditation, seeing an image of another woman, she realized that image was of her own. That was her in her past life. She sits in this meditation, praying to Paramatma, calling him Waheguru, over and over again. And now on this day, Bhai Ramaji, who rushes home to see his daughter, finds his daughter not in the home. She hasn't come back from the Dharamsal. So he tells his wife, I'm not going to eat yet. I want to see my child first. He goes and rushes to the Dharamsal. And there, in the corner of the courtyard, in the Dharamsal, in the Gurdwara, sits Mata Sahib Kaur, with her eyes closed. And Pai Ramaji slowly comes up to her and sits beside her, not trying to break her concentration. But after a while, she opens her eyes and a gush of tears run down her cheek. And she addresses her father and she says, forgive me, father, that I didn't return home today. But I've had a realization. I've realized my purpose in life here. My purpose in life here can only start when I marry Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Bhai Rama Ji, after his attachment for his child, had forgotten this realization that he had had himself at the time of the birth of Mata Sahib Kaur. Now Mata Sahib Kaur has reinforced and brought this sentence that he had heard from Paramatma in his heart. And he realized that, I know, at that time, I've forgotten now, but at that time, I had surrendered you, child. I had said you belong to Guru Gobind Singh Ji. We wouldn't even have had you if it wasn't for Guru Gobind Singh Ji. They now collect Sangat. They all go as a company. These are the years before 1699. Some have written after, but I'm going by the ithihas that's given at Mata Sahib Kaur Deva's Gurdwara in Maharashtra. The Sangat now come to Anandpur Sahib. And there's a Binti made to Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Khalsa Ji, a sad reality now. A lot of the children are looking up on the internet and they're hearing that Guru Gobind Singh Ji only had one wife. They mesh all three beautiful women that deserve to be called Matama and they mesh them into one. And that's why Mata Sundar Kaur's Gurdwara is not being taken care of. That's why the place of where the funeral pyre of Mata Ajit Kaur is not being visited. There's a reason. Gur ki karni kahe tavo. Why do you question Guru Maharaj's karni? Some of us Sikhs, we think that, well, we are only supposed to have one wife. That's why Guru Sahib should have had one wife. So they start meshing all three women into one. But this is the Guru Sahib. Gur ki karni. This is Maharaj's karni. Kahe tavo. Why are you questioning it? These are prane bhagats that are calling out to Paramatma. Maharaj saw that in the 10th form, he's going to give his next form to the Shabd Guru. And there were grants or blessings that had been handed out to these bhagats that, yes, I'll give you an opportunity to wed me. Maaf karna, that I would marry you in that 10th form. There's more behind what you see. So don't deny the existence of Mata Ajit Kaur and Mata Sundar Kaur and Mata Sahib Kaur. At that time, Guru Gobind Singh Ji's marriage with Mata Ajit Kaur and Mata Sundar Kaur had happened. There are places where they were born that exist. We still have it. And all our Pratan Ityaskar believe in this. But the new ones are meshing it together. And on the internet, that's all you find, that Guru Maharaj was only married to Mata Sahib Kaur. That's false. And I'm not going to preach false on this stage. Khalsa Ji, that time, the Sangat had come. And Guru Gobind Singh Ji heard the request. Guru Gobind Singh Ji heard their request. The request was, that please, Sache Pasha, this child has been surrendered to you at the time of birth. Please find a place in your heart and marry this child and give her a permanent home in the house of Guru Nanak Dev Ji. Guru Gobind Singh Ji said, now at this time, 31 years of age, Guru Gobind Singh Ji said, I've been already married. And now there's preparations for something big that's going to come up. But if I do wed her and I accept the request of the Sangat, remember, it was with the request of the Sangat. And the acceptance with Mama Kripal Chand and Mata Gujar Kaur that the first two weddings happened. It wasn't Guru Gobind Singh Ji saying that I'm going to have this many marriages. That's another fact there. So at this time, Guru Gobind Singh Ji says that there will be no other child because now four exist, the four Sahib Jade. No more Bindi Olaad will come about. You have to accept this. If you're to be married to me, Mata Sahib Kaur says to be known as your wife, I'll accept any condition. She matha takes in acceptance, and then the wedding took place. Now, in the few following years, 1699 happened. And when Guru Maharaj had been preparing the Amrit Bhata, the Amrit Bhata that was being prepared for the Khalsa, that five that had been beheaded, to bring them and resurrect them, that Amrit Bhata that had been being prepared by Guru Gobind Singh Ji holding a khanda, lacked one thing at that time. And that was a mother's touch. Guru Gobind Singh, you wanted a mother's touch. Then the three of them deliberated. They talked amongst each other that we have to add something. Add our part to this Amrit Bata. So the three of them prepared something which we call patase. Patase, or these sugar cakes that were prepared at that time. Then a decision was made that the eldest, remember it was the three of them working together as sisters, that the eldest, Mata Ajit Kaur, add this in. But again, it would be recognized as a mother's touch. Now a lot of our panth is confused. They'll say that's Mata Sahib Kaur that did it. But Mata Ajit Kaur was referred to as Mata Sahib too. Mata Sundar Kaur was referred to as Mata Sahib. There was a confusion with the names, where Mata Sahib Kaur literally had the name of Sahib in her name. Mata Ajit Kaur was the eldest. And this privilege was given to her at that time. She had gone on behalf of the three, on behalf of the other two, and gone and added patase into that bata, which Guru Gobind Singh Ji was very happy and pleased with. And he smiled at Mata Ajit Kaur when those patase were placed. Marji gestured, bring them forward. This was a touch of mother. This was a touch of a mother and humility placed into the Khalsa. Mithat Nimi Nanaka Gun Changyaiyan Tat. Added into the Khalsa. That they don't just become power struck or overwhelmed with this power, that this humility exists in their heart. Shortly after, in the years to come, Guru Gobind Singh Ji called upon Mata Sahib Kaur. Mata Sahib Kaur had been fighting a thought and a desire that kept coming in her head, which is naturally wired into a woman, that they want their child at a certain age. She knew the condition that she accepted. There would be no physical relation. There would be no child that she would bring into this world through pregnancy. She would be known as a Kuara Dola. That's what's been coined in our Itihas. As a virgin mother. Well, at that time, Mata Sahib Kaur had been fighting this. Guru Gobind Singh Ji recognized it. And he said that there has been a purpose why she has come into this house. The Mata Sundar Kaur is the mother of Baba Ajit Singh. And Baba Jujar Singh, Jorawar Singh, Baba Fateh Singh, their mother is Mata Ajit Kaur. Well, at this time, Guru Gobind Singh Ji calls upon Mata Sahib Kaur. And he says, Mata Sahib Kaur, come here. She stands next to Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Maharaj Ji sits on the takht. And he says, Khalsa Ji Savdan, meaning concentrate on my next words, that I'm going to tell you a truth that you have to accept. From this day forth, this is your mother. You exist in this world from a father and a mother. And this is your mother. You are to recognize her as your mother. Maharaj Ji knew the need of this mother. Why? Because people that would go into war, they would always come to their mother. Whether now, even now in India, if they go to write an exam, a lot of them, because of a tradition, they would go to their mother and ask for asisa. Like we say in Gurbani, puta mata ki asis. They needed a mother for these blessings. Guru Gobind Singh Ji saw that Mata Sahib Kaur stands for the divine shakti, the divine energy of Paramatma. And he said, Khalsa Ji, from this day forth, this is your mother. This is your mother. And from this day forth, at Amrit Sanchars, the person who becomes a baptized Sikh, who becomes Amritari, is told that your father from this day is Guru Gobind Singh Ji, and your Jagat Mata, your spiritual mother, is Mata Sahib Kaur. Maharaj had solidified it that day, and he turned to Mata Sahib Kaur and he said, this is your child. I've placed them within your lap. And from this day forth, them being your child, they will turn to you for blessings. And when you do hand them and distribute them out, Khalsa Ji, if you look through Mata Sahib Kaur's writing, the writing still exists to this day in Hukam Name after Guru Gobind Singh Ji's time. She writes in the Hukam Name, Tusi mere put farzand ho, Guru Pura, Tuadi deg deg fateh kare. To this day, we have those Hukam Name, and there are many. And in each of them, what does Mata Sahib Kaur do? She hands out blessings to her child. Farzand means you're my child. And Gaur Pura Tuadi Deg Teg Fateh Kare. And this is our noble mother. She says that if these blessings are upon you, it's because the complete Guru Sahib is giving them to you. In her humility, when she hands out blessings, she names the Guru Sahib as the complete Guru and Tuadi Deg Teg Fateh Kare. So Khalsa Ji, now, the Khalsa has a mother known as Mata Sahib Kaur. Then, when Guru Gobind Singh Ji had gone from Anandpur Sahib to Sarsa Nadi, you know this at the Ithihas, I'm not going to go into it in Vistar, I'm not going to go and dive into the deep details, but you know there's a Gurdwara Sahib at Sarsa Nadi called Parivar Vishora. Parivar means family. Vishoda means separated. At that time, Guru Gobind Singh Ji had crossed Sarsa Nadi after completing his nitname and doing Asa Diwar. While Baba Ajit Singh was fighting off the onslaught of forces, Guru Gobind Singh Ji, in that difficult night, Guru Gobind Singh Ji had crossed. Many Singhs and Singhaniya were swept in the waters. The Chote Sahib Jade, Baba Zorawar Singh Ji, Baba Fateh Singh Ji, now were with Mata Gujar Kaur, and they had gone one way. Bhai Mani Singh, Mata Sundar Kaur, and Mata Sahib Kaur have gone another. Bhai Mani Singh directs them towards Delhi. Guru Gobind Singh Ji would work his way to Chamkor Sahib. And there, you know, the story started. The story started of what was already happening as martyrdom. Now, the Parvar, the elder Sahib Jade, and then moving south to Sirhan, the Chote Sahib Jade, had given their lives. They had been martyred. Shaheed ho gaye si. Vade Sahib Jade and Chote Sahib Jade. Mata Sahib Kaur and Mata Sundar Kaur are now in Delhi, and they're hearing little tidbits and news of what's happening. And they're praying. They're folding both hands and keep doing paath over and over again for those lives that are being lost. That they're not lost. They're finding their place in Guru Maharaj's charan. Well, Khalsa Ji, now Guru Gobind Singh Ji has come to Damdama Sahib. And Guru Gobind Singh Ji, being at Damdama Sahib, news has come to Mata Sundar Kaur and Mata Sahib Kaur that have been praying and doing prachar in Delhi. Sikh Sangat has now all collected together because today they're going to be making their way to Sabo Ki Talwandi, Bathinda, and make their way and visit Guru Gobind Singh Ji. They're going to be graced with Guru Gobind Singh Ji's vision. Graced with Guru Gobind Singh Ji's presence, they all make their way to Bathinda, to Damdama Sahib, and as they come, both of the Matama are looking around. They have matha take to Guru Gobind Singh Ji and said that, Sache Patshah, thank you that you've granted this union again. And they look around, where are the Sahib Jade? Where are the Vade Sahib Jade? Where are the Chote Sahib Jade? And then news gets to them. And sorrow comes across their minds. Both of their heads become lowered. And tears start to well up in their eyes. But Guru Maharaj says, you're grieving the loss of our children. Don't grieve their loss. Char mue to kya pya? Guru Gobind Singh Ji says, so what if those four have gone in the panth? Jeevat kei hazar. There's thousands. The biggest Amrit Sanchar to date was held in Damdama Sahib. Khalsa Ji, the biggest Amrit Sanchar. The first one in Anandpur Sahib, but the biggest one is in Damdama Sahib, where the Ginti had gone into the Hazar. Khalsa Ji, at that time, Guru Gobind Singh Ji said, and this Gurdwara Sahib is still there, where this meeting took place. It's right behind the Takht of Damdama Sahib. Make sure you take your children to visit this Gurdwara Sahib, known as Gurdwara Mata Sundar Kaur and Gurdwara Mata Sahib Kaur. That place is still right behind the Takht of Sri Damdama Sahib. Khalsa Ji, there Mata Sahib Kaur ne paran kita. She made a promise that she's not going to leave the side of Guru Gobind Singh Ji. She's going to stay with Guru Gobind Singh Ji, and in the morning, she will not eat. She will not eat until she sees Guru Gobind Singh Ji's blessed sight. Until she sees Maharaj's darshan, unhne bhojan nahi chakna. Mata Sahib Kaur di paran si. So Khalsa Ji, Mata Sahib Kaur now accompanies Guru Gobind Singh Ji, who says, we have to go south. Dakhanwal jana hon. We have to go towards the south. And as they make their way south, they come to Delhi. In Delhi, there was a lot of Sikh Sangat. Guru Maharaj Ji had fought a war there, had killed the son of Aurangzeb, Azim Shah, and brought another son, Bahadur Shah, onto the Takht. There the Sangat of Delhi said, Sache Patsha, we don't want you to go. We want you to stay. Please accept this request. Maharaji said, no. The Lord's will is I go south. The Lord's will, Parameshwar da paana, main dakhan wal jaawa. I have to go towards the south. Then at that time, they said, then, Matavanu, we have a strong love since the day they left Sarsa Nadi and they were directed here by Mani Singh. We don't want them to go. We want to keep the Matava here. Guru Gobind Singh Ji says, if this is your pleasure, then I'll tell them they should remain here. But both of the Matava looked and said that we want to stay with Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Mata Sundar Kaur then accepted to stay, but Mata Sahib Kaur said that, Sache Patsha, no, I have to stay by your side. I'm going to stay by your side. Guru Maharaj Ji said, Jidna Karo, you should stay here with the Sangat. I've told you now. But Mata Sahib Kaur said, no, I'm coming with you. Why, Sache Patsha? Are you separating me from you? I barely survived the last separation from Sarsa Nadi. Now you tell me to separate from you here. I respect the Sangat in Delhi, but my place is to be beside you. Guru Maharaj Ji says, then there's a condition. Now at the time of marriage, Maharaj Ji had placed a condition before. Now he places a condition. He says, what if another war comes? What if there's another war? Will you go on the battlefield? She says, yes. I'll take up the shield. I'll take up the sword. And I will proudly go onto the battlefield. Guru Gobind Singh Ji says, then fine, you can accompany me. Khalsa Ji, if you take your children, if you go yourself to Damdama Sahib, one of Mata Sahib Kaur's shields is there in the Takht of Damdama Sahib, still preserved. The shield of Mata Sahib Kaur. That tells us she used to carry a shield. She used to carry a kirpan, an enormous kirpan by her side as well. So Khalsa Ji, now Maharaji makes his way south. He comes to Burhanapur. And then from Burhanapur, they make their way to Nanded. Nanded, where does Guru Maharaji stop? Is Gurdwara Hirakat. Gurdwara Hirakat was the initial spot that where Maharaji had set up a tent and set up his place of residence. That's where Maharaji stopped first. At one point there, now if you go in Gurdwara Hirakat, and you matha tek, there's a photo of Guru Gobind Singh Ji drawing back an arrow and shooting it. Maharaji had shot an arrow that landed where now the Takht of Sri Hazur Sahib is. And he claimed it with his arrow. When there's argument that no, this is our place, some of the other people there said, no, this belongs to us. Maharaji says, where this arrow is, dig up. And you'll find my pratan, or my ancient possessions from Satyog. And when those items came up, Khalsaji, they all said and declared it to be the land of Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Now that was Guru Gobind Singh Ji's Pishla Tapastan. One Tapastan Himkund Sahib. One Tapastan in Nanded Sahib. And one day, when Maharaji had gone out to do the Udar of Mula Khatri, Mula Khatri, if you know from Sialkot, when Guru Nanak Dev Ji had visited there, there was Mula Khatri. And because he never opened the door to Guru Nanak Dev Ji when Maharaji was calling him, he fell into the life of an animal. And then another animal. And then another animal until the time of Guru Gobind Singh Ji, when he was on that land in Maharashtra as a rabbit. As a rabbit. And when Guru Gobind Singh Ji shot out an arrow and slayed that rabbit, some said, why did you hit that innocent rabbit with your arrow, Sachi Pasha? Maharaji says, ask the rabbit. They said, what? And at that time, the spirit that was sitting, Jai Rubetisi, within that Kargosh, within that rat, came up. And it spoke. And he said that I've been wandering in the Chaurasi Lakh, waiting for the 10th form of Guru Nanak Dev Ji to come. Maharaji was doing the Adar. Maharaji was saving these species out of the Chaurasi Lakh. Those arrows would hit and they would be liberated. At that time, near there, Gurdwara Shikar Ghat, near there, Mata Sahib Kaur had accompanied Guru Gobind Singh Ji. And Maharaji turned to Mata Sahib Kaur and he said, near there, he said, do you recognize this spot? She said, it's a very peaceful spot. Mata Sahib Kaur looks and it seems familiar, but she can't put her finger on it. And Guru Gobind Singh Ji turns to her. He says to Sahib Devan, Sahib Kaur, that this is your Pratan Tapastan. That Maharaji chose to bring her to the south for this reason. Because Guru Gobind Singh Ji was going to show and reveal to the Khalsa Panth his Pratan Tapastan, and then reveal to the Panth their Mata's Pratan Tapastan. Guru Gobind Singh Ji had shown her this spot and she wanted to stay here now. She wanted to do her meditation here because her mind would easily absorb into the Lord by staying there at where now Gurdwara Mata Sahib Kaur. The Gurdwara's initial name, like I told you, Gurdwara Ad Shakti Jagat Mata Mata Sahib Kaur the Pratan Tapastan. That's the pura name of that Gurdwara Sahib. And there, Mata Sahib Kaur had set up a tent. And Maharaji said, don't worry, I'm not far from you. When I go out with my Gursikhs, every day I'll come to this spot. And you as their mother, feed your children. She would prepare langar. She would bring water from the Godavari, prepare prashade, starting from Amrit Vela, do her nitname and prepare prashade, and she would feed it to the Sikh Sangat that would come there. To this day, Khalsaji, don't ever do and then make the mistake of going to Mata Sahib Kaur's Gurdwara and not eating. That's your mother's Gurdwara. Your mother has a cha that just as a mother has, and she has happiness to see their children growing up and are fed. Mata Sahib Kaur has a cha. She has excitement to see all you as her children go there, matha take and eat. There still is preserved Mata Sahib Kaur's Pratan Tapastan. That spot is still preserved there. Well, Khalsaji, now time has come. And what has happened is that Guru Gobind Singh Ji called Mata Sahib Kaur. When he called her, he said to her, Sahib Kaur, I have a hukum now that this time you won't refuse. You cannot refuse it this time. She knew right away. And she said, Sachi Pasha, please, Please, I ask you, why? Don't separate me from your charan. Don't separate me from your charan. Guru Gobind Singh Ji says, remember, Sahib Kaur, I had given a leniency. And I said that you can come with me. But this time, you have to listen to me. You are to go with Bhai Mani Singh and go to Delhi and meet with your sister, Mata Sundar Kaur. Respectfully, she would respect her like her sister, Mata Sundar Kaur. She said, then why, Sache Pasha? And then she figured out that Maharaji's time is coming, of 1708. 9 months, 9 days, and 9 kadiyan, Mata Sahib Kaur, exactly to that day. And now she has to accept Maharaji's pana and accept Maharaji's command to leave and go to Delhi. And she says, Sache Pasha, mera parna. It's my vow that I do not eat until I have your darshan. I have your blessed sight. Then, tum bin mora lamb na koi, dekh ancho jal pojan doi. She says, I don't eat until I see your vision. Haji vi gursikh, they'll do darshan of Guru Granth Sahib Ji, they'll do their nitnim and then they'll eat Khalsa Ji. It was Mata Sahib Kaur that was the great influence behind this maryada. Mata Sahib Kaur had instilled this in her gursikhs. Well, Mata Sahib Kaur was told, Maharaji called for certain shastras. These shastras originally belonged to Guru Gobind Singh Ji's grandfather. Who is Guru Gobind Singh Ji's grandfather? Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji, our sixth guru. And Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji says, take these shastras. Mata Sahib Kaur, you represent the divine power of the Lord. When the divine power takes up 5 elements, Sada Panjputak Sarira, our body is made of 5 elements. Then you manifested. You represent that power of the Lord. When we say Gurudev Mata, a translation of that is the Gurudev's Shakti that's acting motherly. The Lord's Shakti, divine power that's acting in a motherly nature to raise this creation. That's Gurudev Mata. And Mata Sahib Kaur represented that. He handed those shastras because they, shastras also are a prateek, represent Shakti as well. And he said to Mata Sahib Kaur, look, take these shastras and in the morning unsheathe them. Do respect of them. And then, after doing Ishnan yourself, sit down by them and do your prayers. When you do your prayers and you finish and you do your adas, through those shastras, main aap pragat hunga. Guru Maharaj Ji says, I'll reveal my vision through those shastras. Maharaj Ji's words, Khalsa Ji, those shastras are still in Delhi, in the Gurdwara Sahib of Mata Sahib Kaur and Mata Sundar Kaur, in Delhi. They're up against the wall. When you do prakarma and you start your prakarma, you'll see them on your left-hand side. And there's a caption underneath them saying, these are the shastras of Mata Sahib Kaur that were given by Guru Gobind Singh Ji. And from these, she would see Guru Gobind Singh Ji. And then she would eat in her day. Well, Khalsa Ji, Maharaj Ji, Guru Gobind Singh Ji, in the same granth which we call Sarbalo granth, where we read, Khalsa Mera Roop Hai Khas. We also read a pankti that inspires us and tells us who our mother is. Mat Bhagavati Pita Kal Purkh God Liyo De Khas Pali. This is the line from Sarbalo Granth that Guru Gobind Singh Ji had cited to the Khalsa Panth. Mata Sahib Kaur, with tears, has left with Bhai Mani Singh to Delhi and met up with Mata Sundar Kaur in embrace. And on the opposite side, in 1708, in Nanded, Guru Gobind Singh Ji has turned to the Khalsa. Then now, time has come. I leave this cloak. And my light merges into Tan Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji. Khalsa Ji, don't have sorrow within your heart. Your Guru Sahib, Jo Mam Saath Chahe Kar Baat, Granth ji pade, vichare saath. If you want to talk to me, talk to Guru Granth Sahib ji. I'll talk through Guru Granth Sahib ji to you. Jere mere bache honge, paath karnge, paath di vichar karnge. Main unnana galla karunga Guru Granth Sahib ji vichon. And Guru Gobind Singh ji said, sog na karo. What's going to take care of you? I placed you into the lap of your mother. Mat Bhagwati. Your mother is Shakti. The divine Shakti of Paramatma. Shakti is not separate from Paramatma. Kal heen kala sanjogat. Akal purkh ades. Kala sanjogat. Paramatma vakrini avdi Shakti ton. Shakti is a reflection of Paramatma. Mata Sahib Kaur is a reflection of Paramatma. Your Mata is with you, Khalsa ji. But what have we done? I salute those that organize this program, that remember Mata Sahib Kaur. I salute those across the globe that are remembering their Mata, because over the years we have forgotten our Mata. You can come before Guru Granth Sahib Ji and call to your Mata through Guru Granth Sahib Ji. But how many have? And now, Mata Sahib Kaur is living in Delhi. Now Delhi, she is with Mata Sundar Kaur. Mata Sundar Kaur is providing the leadership to the Khalsa Panth. And Mata Sahib Kaur is immersed in prayers. She's just over and over doing her prayers. Time to time, she sends out Hukam Name to direct the Khalsa Panth. And she would live her life up to 1747. When one day she turns and she matha takes after doing darshan of Guru Gobind Singh Ji through the Shastras. And in 1747, she turns to Mata Sundar Kaur. Pane. She respects Mata Sundar Kaur as a sister and she says, Pane, that this is my time. I make my leave. Sadra agya. Akal Purkh has sent his message for me to leave too. But what I want you to do is take my hand. And when I lie down, I want to feel your hand within my hand as I leave this world. Mata Sundar Kaur would be her by her bedside, as the rest of the Khalsa Panth. And she said that do my cremation, do my funeral. Where Guru Har Krishan Sachi Pasha's funeral was held. That's called Gurdwara Bala Sahib. And at Gurdwara Bala Sahib, right next to where Guru Har Krishan Sahib's cremation happened, funeral pyre happened, right next to it, you will find, in respect, stands a Gurdwara, a Mata Sahib Kaur. Mata Sahib Kaur, and then later on Mata Sundar Kaur, would also want her desire to be cremated at the same spot as well. She has left this world now. But she has not left. She's still with the Lord. And the Lord is omnipresent. The Lord exists everywhere. So I'm going to tell you a story of how certain children, certain noble children, have remembered their mother. Well, in 1922, this is the story of Gurdwara Mata Sahib Kaur Deva. How did that Gurdwara come about? Well, when the Khalsa Panth would go, first of all, they wouldn't go much towards Takht Hazur Sahib. A lot of them said that Shahidan Da Pehra. They would say that Shahidan Da Pehra, that is surrounded by angels there. And these angels make it a difficult time for those that aren't baptized. At that time, there was a Nihang Singh named Baba Mit Singh, Brahmgyani. Khalsa ji, I hope that today you remember Mata Sahib Kaur and also Baba Mit Singh. Because when Baba Mit Singh made his way to Hazur Sahib, he was one of those noble children, said that I'm not leaving this spot without visiting my Mata's Astan. He said that I'm not leaving until I visit my mother's place. He went there and there was another noble soul. His name was Bhai Hira Singh Dudatari. Dudatari was his name because he only drank milk. He only drank milk. That's how he survived, just by drinking milk. Bhai Hira Singh used to live there nearby. and take care of that spot. But he knew this was not in his capability. And when Baba Mit Singh came to that Astan, well, everybody came and said that we'll stay here. There's no Gurdwara Sahib there. There's a Thada. What's a Thada? It's a platform. And there's a Nishan Sahib. No Gurdwara Sahib. But how could it be that Mata Sahib Kaur doesn't have a Gurdwara Sahib there? Well, Khalsa Ji, Baba Mit Singh sat there, and oh, the bitch, AG cha paida hoi that he couldn't sleep there. He said that, no, I have to get up. I've come to this spot after thinking about it for so much. Now I have the opportunity and I'm going to sleep here? No, mani songa. Otke. He got up and he sat by the Thada Sahib. And he folded his hands and started to recite Waheguru over and over again. And then he fell into a deep meditation. When the night had passed, Amrit Vela had come, he heard a voice. And the voice said, my beloved child, how long will your mother's place remain without the presence of Sangat? The kinna chair, tode mata di asthan, sunni rahogi Sangat to bina. He heard a voice talk to him, communicate to him. It was the voice of Mata Sahib Kaur talking to the child that is sitting up in remembrance of Mata Sahib Kaur through Simran. Mata Sahib Kaur also said, son, I awaited your arrival. Those are my children. Those are the Sangha that come here, that arrive here, leave without being fed. While I remained here, I made sure any of the six Sangha, my children that come here, never leave without food. And now I see them. And they're not being fed. They leave without being fed and their stomachs are hungry. I cannot tolerate this. She said to Baba Mit Singh in a vision, when will the lap of your mother flourish again? Todi mata di god kadon hariyavalta vich phir aogi? When will it flourish again? And this echoed in Baba Mit Singh's head. This echoed in Baba Mit Singh's head. Baba Hira Singh, Duda Tari convinced Baba Mit Singh to stay here. And that echo of when will my lap, Mataji's lap, still flourish, that echoed in Baba Mit Singh's head. So Khalsaji, then what happened? He took up the seva. Khalsaji, think of it. We still sleep in our homes. He's sleeping in the ground of a forest, next to Mata Sahib Kaur's Thada. And what does he do? After 15 days, some Sangat comes. And whatever money comes, he goes and gets langar prepared or kara prasad. He prepares, initially it was kara prasad that was given to the Sangat. He'd bring water from the Godavari. He'd bring pitchers of water from the Godavari. And then kara prasad banake Sangat nu vandda hunda si. The kathinaiya, the difficulty of staying there cannot be described of what he did. But he went on. He went on with the love of his mother. And that's why we have to mention him today as well. So, I'm going to tell you a story. When some Singhs from Amritsar ventured there, Amritari Singhs came and they said that we're not going to leave without visiting Mataji's Astan. There were some Sikhs that had this bhavna, this nature. And they came and they searched for Mataji's Astan and they came there and they found Baba Mit Singh. Thorje Prabandh Agge Vadyasi, it had progressed. And when they came and Matha take there, they said, Baba Ji, Appa Mataji de Astan to shake bina nahi jana. That we're not going to leave this spot without being fed. Baba Ji said that your mother is happy to feed you here. He said, Kada prasad khulle vrtao. They openly vrta kara prasad. Baba Ji says here, first jal shako, ishnan karo, ethe paath karo, and apa prabandh kar de hain, we'll bring kara prasad. Well, there was now other individuals, other sevadars that were living there, and they came up to Baba Ji, and they said that, Baba Ji, we have no butter left. How are we going to make kara prasad? We have flour, we have sugar, We can get water. But there's no butter. How are we going to prepare kara prasad? You promised the sangat kara prasad. We don't have the rust. We don't have the provisions. Babaji says, then go get the provisions. Why are you looking at me? Go to the village and get butter. They went. They went and followed the request from Baba Mit Singh. They went to the nearby villages. But after going to four villages, they came back and they said that, Babaji, nothing. We've got nothing. Babaji says, then don't worry. Don't drown in your worry. That Mataji, Mataji's going to sabab banadogi. He closed his eyes for a minute. It was as if a lot of people said that he talked to Mataji on a regular basis. Now, Gurmukh Akath Kahani, that Gurmukh de jiri andarli birti hai, oda akath tha, das nahi sakde tuhanu. But jiri das de hai, baron, ki hai gaya gur sikh that had seen Baba Mit Singh, they said that he communicated with Mataji all the time. And he opened his eyes. He looked at the Sangat very seriously and the Sevadars and he said, take this picture. Take this picture and go to the Godavari. And bring back water from the Godavari, then do Ardas there. When you take the water from the Godavari, do Ardas. Say, Mataji, please, this is the Sangat's request. That provide butter for us through this water. The first Sevadar went, but reluctant. How is water going to turn into butter? But Babaji said that, Mani Shanka Chona, I don't want doubt in your head. So when you're coming back, make sure you're doing Mool Mantra Da Paath when you're coming back. Well, as they returned, well, they got to Godavari. The Sevadar collected water in the pitcher. He did Ardas. Mataji, Tusi koi na koi sabab vartao. Show us. And turn this water into butter. Bring it before us so we can do seva for the Sangat. Your children are starving and they've requested food. We have nothing to give to them. Well, at that time, the Sangat came back with that water. Now they heard water through the pitcher the whole way. And they'd continually done Mool Mantra Da Paath. There they came to Baba Mit Singh. Baba Mit Singh had prepared chani or sugar water, sugar dissolved in water. And one side there's a bata with flour. Baba Mit Singh, can they aage? Then take that pitcher and place the butter within the flour. When they opened the pitcher, they looked and they still saw water. Khalsa ji pani si, but we know je kada prasad banona. You don't add water until near the end. You add butter and flour. And then you add the chani. Well, Khalsa ji, he said to them, that pour the contents of the pitcher inside of that bata with the flour. They said, chalo, theek hai, sat bachan Babaji. Babaji, they picked up the pitcher. And as they started to pour, they saw water. But when that water fell into the flour, they saw butter. Khalsa ji, they saw butter. They kept looking. As they kept pouring, they saw water in the pitcher. But when it would touch the flour, it became butter. Babaji then, after this was done, he folded his hands and he said, "Da hath jodo, khade ki dekh de, hath jodo, and thank your mother. Your mother has provided butter for you." He's like, "You have your mouths open. But your mouth should be in prayer. And your hands should be folded, thanking your mother." Khalsa ji, ajiyan cheejan vaapardi siyan, os tarti de upar, all the time. And still do at Mata Sahib Kaur's Gurdwara, and all across the globe, where she's remembered. They said, the Sikh Sangat said, it's not our reach. It can only be done by a child that has a spiritual avastha, as Baba Mit Singh. And Baba Mit Singh, who said that, Mera saskar hor koi isthan te na kareo, ithe kareo. I want to remain in the lap of my mata. And there now to this day, you'll find a memorial made for Baba Mit Singh. So Khalsa ji, this hopefully gives you a small picture of our beloved mata. We do say Gurdev Pita and Gurdev Mata. That Mata is the reflection of that divine Shakti. We can't see it now, but even now, people in the science realm, in the science field, are accepting that there's an energy that's working amongst us that we can't fully capture, fully understand. Because we're thinking with a consciousness that's being given by a supreme consciousness. The ground of existence is from that consciousness we call Chetan Srup Paramatma. His Shakti works around us. And that's a motherly Shakti. We say, as in the manner that mother raises us, right, in her god, in her lap. So in that manner, we recognize Paramatma with his Shakti being the form of Mata Sahib Kaur. Now, I end. If I made any mistakes, please forgive me. But before I leave, I want you to do a bit of simran and let's remember Mata Sahib Kaur. Fold your hands. And as Mata Sahib Kaur still sits in Guru Granth Sahib Ji, face towards Guru Granth Sahib Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Japo, Tan Mata, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Now Khalsa Ji, Saryan Di Niyav Aajon Di, Tusi Bacche Ho, you're the children of this Mata, why can't you remember on her on this day? I want everybody, and teach your children as well. This is your mother, and she sits within Guru Granth Sahib Ji, in that light. So, let's try this again. Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Japo. Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Japo, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. I'm going to do this one more time because I don't feel that everybody's saying it. Now the sons, I'm going to get the daughters to say it. But this is what Baba Isha Singh Ji used to do. He used to get the Singhs and the Singhniya to do it, but turn by turn. I'm going to get the Singhs to say it, so I get everybody on their side, and then turn to the Kaurs, and then as children, sons and daughters of Mata Sahib Kaur, kyunke likhya bhi aega, tan jane di mao joda jodiye, evi pankti hondiya, joda, the Singhs, jodiye, the Singhniya. The Singh Singhniya are of this blessed mother of Mata Sahib Kaur. So, Singhanu bentiya, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Uchi Awaaz. One more time, Singhs. Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Now to the Singhniya. Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Again to the daughters of Mata Sahib Kaur, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji, Tan Mata Sahib Kaur Ji. Now last time Katyane, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Tan Janendi Mao, Japo, Tan Janendi Mao, ਤਨ ਜਨੇਂਦੀ ਤਨ ਜਨੇਂਦੀ ਤਨ ਜਨੇਂਦੀ ਮਾਓ ਤਨ ਮਾਤਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਕੌਰ ਜੀ 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 ਸੋ ਪੁਲਚੁੱਕ ਖਿਮਾ ਕਰਨੀ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਜੀ ਇਫ ਆਈ ਮੇਡ ਐਨੀ ਮਿਸਟੇਕਸ ਵਾਇਲ ਟਾਕਿੰਗ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਫੋਰਗਿਵ ਮੀ ਆਈ ਹੈਵਨ ਡਨ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਅ ਬ੍ਰੋਕਨ ਸਪੀਕਰ I don't have any knowledge proper that I can speak on such a blessed mother. But when nobody gets on stage and talks about our mother, then in certain circumstances that I do feel an urge to get up on stage. And in my broken language, I've tried to share some stories that hopefully open up the life of Mata Sahib Kaur. You're blessed. And this holy saint, this holy woman that we call our mother, You should be honored to have such a mother. So forgive me if I made any mistakes. Bodhi hai achut hai par brahm abnasi agnas He puran hai sarv main dukh panjan gun taas He sanghi hai nirankar He nirgun sab tek He gobind hai gun nidan Jaake sadab bek He aparampar harare Habi ovanar He santai ke sadasang Nedara adar He thakur ondasro Main nirgun gun nahi koi Nanak dije naam dan Rakho ye pro Islok Aai prab sarnagati ਕਿਰਪਾ ਨਿਧ ਦਿਆਲ ਏਕ ਅੱਖਰ ਹਰ ਮਨ ਬਸਤ ਨਾਨਕ ਹੋਤ ਨਿਆਲ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਮ ਜਹਾਜ ਹੈ ਚਰੇ ਸੋ ਤਰੇ ਪਾਰ ਜੋ ਸਰਦਾ ਕਰ ਸੇਮ ਦੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਪਾਰ ਉਤਾਰ ਨਾਰ ਜੋ ਸਰਦਾ ਕਰ ਸੇਮ ਦੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਪਾਰ ਉਤਾਰ ਨਾਰ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ ਵਾਹ